Steve here again from Photoshop Essentials. Adjustment layers are a great way to improve or add effects to your image non-destructively. And if you're not sure how they work, a great way to start is with the adjustments presets. You'll find them in the adjustments panel. If you're not seeing the panel, go up to the window menu and choose adjustments. Only a few presets are shown at first, and you can preview how they will look with your image by hovering your cursor over the thumbnails. To see the names of the presets, click the icon in the upper right, and then you can hover over the names to preview the effects. I'll switch back to the thumbnails. To view all of the presets, click the More button. There are 32 presets in total, and they're divided into groups. So we have Portraits, Landscape, Photo Repair, Creative, Black and White, and Cinematic. You may need to twirl the group open to see the presets inside it. And again, you can hover over each thumbnail in the group to preview the result. To select a preset, click on its thumbnail. I'll select the Moody Blues preset from the Portraits group. And this one adds a bluish tint and makes the image brighter. In the Layers panel, the preset is added as a layer group above your image, with the name of the preset as the name of the group. And inside the group are the adjustment layers included with the preset. Some presets have a single adjustment layer, and others, like this one, have two or even three. So this one adds a photo filter adjustment and a curves adjustment. You can toggle the layer group, open or closed, or toggle the group on and off to view the image with and without the preset. And you can toggle the adjustment layers on and off to see how each one contributes to the overall effect. If I turn off the curves adjustment, it's easier to see that the photo filter adjustment is adding the blue tint. And if I turn the photo filter off and curves back on, the curves adjustment is brightening the image. And when I turn both of them back on, we get the combined effect. So if I like the blue tint, but not the brightening, I can just turn the curves adjustment off. To delete a preset, just drag its layer group down onto the trash bin. And because adjustment layers are non-destructive, deleting the preset restores the original image. Along with turning adjustment layers on and off, you can also edit their settings. I'll select the faded preset. And this one fades the color saturation. In the Layers panel, we see the faded group above my image, and this preset includes a single hue saturation adjustment. To edit the settings for an adjustment, double-click on its icon. And the settings open in the Properties panel. So here we see that the faded preset lowered the saturation to negative 40. I could drag the saturation slider to the left to fade the color even more, or drag it to the right to bring back more of the original color. And if you want to restore the original settings for the preset, just click the Reset to Defaults button. I'll delete this preset so we can look at one more way that an adjustment layer could be affecting your image. Some of the presets are a bit sneaky and can leave you wondering what's going on. I'll choose the Strong Contrast preset from the Photo Repair section. But this one makes the contrast too strong, so I need to dial it back. In the Layers panel, we see my layer group with a single curves adjustment inside it. I'll double-click on its icon to view the curve in the Properties panel. But notice that the curve is still set to its default values, with a straight diagonal line running from black in the lower left to white in the upper right. If you're not familiar with how curves work, what this means is that the curve is not actually doing anything. None of the original brightness values have been changed. So how is this preset adding so much contrast? Well, the answer is in the Layers panel. Notice that this preset changed the blend mode of the curves adjustment from Normal to Overlay, which is one of the blend modes that increases contrast. If I set the blend mode back to Normal, the effect disappears. And when I choose Overlay, we get that higher contrast look. To reduce the contrast, I can try a different blend mode, like Soft Light, for a more subtle effect. And since the contrast is still too strong, I can lower the opacity of the adjustment layer. I'll lower it to 30%. And that looks better. So keep in mind that while most of the adjustments presets will change the settings in the Properties panel, a few of them use the Blend mode instead. And finally, if you're a more advanced Photoshop user, you don't want to use the adjustments presets, and you don't want them taking up space in the Adjustments panel, you can hide them. Just click the panel's menu icon and switch from Modern View to Classic View. And now we're seeing just the single adjustment layers. You can always switch to the Modern View to bring the presets back. And there we have it. That's how to use the adjustments presets in Photoshop. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to my channel for more Photoshop tutorials. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. I'm Steve Patterson from Photoshop Essentials.